The Flash, issue number 33. The Flash seems to be a series that I tend to do a lot of videos on. I've already done like two or three so far on this one. I wasn't going to originally do a video on this issue, except for the fact that, hey, it's the Dark Knight's Metal tie-in, so let's do it. So, I've mentioned this in, I can't even remember what video, but there was a previous video where I said, the thing about the Dark Knight's Metal, it seems like it doesn't affect anyone else, like everyone else's story, like everyone else's series doesn't seem to have any Dark Knight's Metal like references or anything like that, except for like a very small few. This kind of changes that, I guess, but it does a really bad job at it, I guess. Let me just say this issue is really awesome. I love it. I like this issue. It's really good. However, I feel like this issue should be a mini series. I don't feel like it should be considered canon, or it deserves the number 33 number. Well, I don't want to say deserves, because like I said, it's a really good issue. I don't think it should be a number 33. I don't think it should be Flash 33. Flash 33 should be something else. And here's why I say that. This issue destroys continuity with the Flash. The Flash series, for anyone who doesn't read it, there's a bunch of small arcs, basically like 3 to 4 issue arcs. And the Flash, not counting this one, had 32 issues. So 32 divided by 4 and you get 8. So there's been about 8 arcs. Yeah, that seems about right. And the thing is, you can jump into the beginning of every arc and not be too lost, because DC does a really good job of explaining what has happened in the previous arc through Barry Allen's like intro. Barry Allen always starts with, my name is Barry Allen, I'm the fastest man alive, or something like that. And then he kind of explains what's been happening with him lately. So like I said, you can jump into the beginning of any arc, not be completely lost. But the thing that I like is that while every arc kind of stands on its own, what happens in the previous arc carries on over to the next arc. So let me just kind of give a rundown of some of the arcs, because this is going to explain my reasoning for why this issue should not be number 33. So in the first arc, Barry basically comes, an agent, gets the powers of the Speed Force, and Barry and him go out and fight crime. And then later on, that agent turns out to become a villain. He becomes Godspeed. And he uses he's kind of like the Punisher in that criminals should be killed. Like, they shouldn't have a chance to live. Like, they shouldn't go to prison, because then they can just break out and start hurting people all over again. There's also the fact that you might think, he doesn't sound too bad. Except for the fact that a bunch of other people also got the powers of the Speed Force. And Godspeed went and killed them so he can take their power so he can be faster. So he was not just killing villains and criminals. He was killing good people as well. And other people had the Speed Force as well. There was like, maybe 20 people altogether. And Barry was in charge of this STARS facility where he would help train the other speedsters. And one of them was a woman named Mina, who Barry Allen got romantically involved with. And then at the end of the Godspeed arc, Godspeed killed her. And Barry was kind of like depressed and stuff like that. And that was kind of like the motivation for him to get back with Iris, was that he kind of felt like, I shouldn't be alone kind of thing. So then other arcs happened. He met the new Barry, which anyone who's read Flash 52, so 52 Barry. Not 50 Barry, why am I saying Wally? He meant new Wally, the new 52 Wally West. And then there's like other arcs and stuff like that. And then there was one, I think I did two videos on, where Reverse Flash kidnaps him and Iris, brings him to the future. He reveals to Iris that Barry is really the Flash. Then he tells them that in the future, they get married, they have kids, and then their kids inherit the Speed Force powers, and they use the Speed Force powers to destroy the city. And then that kind of pisses Barry off, so he starts fighting Reverse Flash. And then I did a video on this exact issue that I'm talking about. It ends with Iris killing Reverse Flash with this gun, and then they go back into the present day, and Iris doesn't want anything to do with Barry for a while. Not she basically she wants her distance as she kind of deals with everything that's going on. But because of that fight, Barry took Reverse Flash's negative speed force, and then the next arc was him trying to learn to control his negative his speed force powers, and it ended with Wally basically saying, you know what, you help me learn my powers, I'm gonna help you control your you help me learn to control my powers, so I'm gonna try to help you learn to control this these new negative speed force powers. And then just basically because Barry has been like in a depressive slump, his work has suffered, his work at the crime scene, I forgot what that was it's called, it has kind of suffered, so he's been transferred over to, oh my God, I can't believe I forgot the name of it, the prison that that's in the Flash series that all of like Flash's enemies go to, basically Flash's version of Arkham. I can't remember what the name of it is, but it's basically like Alcatraz. It's like a high security prison on an island, and Barry and one of his coworkers get transferred over there. And the last issue was basically like the start of a new arc where Barry and his coworker are now working at this prison, the prison that has all of Barry's villains, all of his Rogue Gallery villains, as well as Godspeed, who recognizes Barry, obviously. And then the issue ended with Barry finishing his first shift, like his first day on the job, and he's about to head home when he meets Mina, the girl that he was in a relationship and that he assumed had died. And she basically arrives and just said, like, you know, miss me, Barry? And then that's how it ends. So that was the end of the last issue. Then we get this issue, which completely ignores all that. Everything I just said, ignore it. Because Mina's not here. Flash doesn't work at the prison. Flash doesn't have the negative speed force, or at least if he does, it's not mentioned in any way. Nothing that happened in the previous issues or previous arcs is brought up at all. And I'm like, I feel like that just kind of destroys everything. Like, it destroys the series. It's almost like the previous 32 issues meant nothing. I mean, what are you gonna do? Are you gonna like have a little mini arc to tie in with Dark Knight's Metal? And then you're gonna go back to where you left off with issue number 32? That doesn't make any sense. I mean, Barry literally just met Mina, a girl that he was in love with, that he assumed was dead. She's alive now. And then what, he's gonna like pretend that that she never came to him, that never happened, and just go on doing his thing during the Dark Knight's Metal tie-in, and then after that's done, he's like, oh yeah, that's right. Mina's still alive. Let me go finally talk to her after 5 issues. That just, I don't know. I'm like almost 10 minutes into this, and I still haven't gotten into this actual issue. But yeah, that's my biggest problem with this issue, is the fact that it just completely destroys continuity. But let's get rid of that, and let's just jump right into the actual issue. So we start where issue number 3 of Dark Knight's Metal kind of took place, where we have Barry and Steel trying to get Superman into the dimension where he can find Bruce, and we all know how that turned out. And if you don't, well, you can go watch that video that I did. So yeah, he gets Superman into the dimension, and then he tries to contact the other Justice League members to ask how they're doing on their end, and basically they all get attacked by the well, they all get sucked into this, like, what looks like a boom tube, but it's not a boom tube. Or if it is, it's not Cyborg's boom tube. It might be Murder Machine's boom tube. But yeah, everyone gets sucked in except for Flash and Steel. They get attacked by Murder Machine and Devastator, who I'm kind of interested to see how his origin story is going to be. I hope it's a lot better than the Merciless, because the Merciless was lame. That was a terrible that was a terrible one shot. But yeah, we get a fight, and the fight is basically Murder Machine and Devastator curb stomping Steel and Flash. I mean, Murder Machine literally grabs Steel's hammer and breaks it, and Devastator just beats the heck out of Flash, as well as he destroys the cosmic tower or tuning fork, I guess is what they call it. Flash goes to rush after Devastator, and he accidentally ends up going into the boom tube, and he arrives at Central City, which we see is all destroyed. And we can see why, if you watched the video that I did for the Red Menace. It kind of explains all that. While here, he sees Iris and Wally, who are like old. I guess they had their life force sucked out of them. And then Flash falls through a hole. And then basically, he tries to communicate with all the other Justice League members. And then he finds out that all the Justice League members are in the Batcave. So Flash is in the Batcave, all the other Justice League members are in the Batcave. But each Batcave, like, they're not in the same Batcave, they're in different Batcaves. And each one is tailor-made to mess with and destroy the Justice League members. So like in Flash's, he sees like all of his like rogue galleries like in tubes. I don't know, the Flash's, I'll admit, the Flash's is kind of weak, his version. Hal Jordan's is pretty cool. Hal Jordan's is basically, he's like in a Batcave surrounded by these demonic creatures that look a lot like Dawnbreaker's constructs. Aquaman's is cool. Aquaman's, he's basically like underwater in a ship graveyard, which I thought looks pretty awesome. And Wonder Woman's isn't too bad either. She it looks like she's like in an underground cave, and there's a bunch of mechs. That seems kind of weird. I don't really associate Wonder Woman with sci-fi technology, but yeah, I guess there's like basically a bunch of mechs that she has to battle. And each Justice League member gets attacked by like their dark version. So Hal gets attacked by Dawnbreaker, Flash gets attacked by Red Menace, and so on and so forth. And that's how the issue ends. And then I guess the next issue, the next tie-in, is going to be the next Justice League issue number 32. But yeah, that was the Flash issue number 33. Like I said, I like the issue. I kind of glossed over a couple of things, but that's just because if I went into detail, this video would be way too long, because it was already like almost like 10 minutes before I actually got into the actual issue. But yeah, good issue, awesome issue. I actually really enjoyed it. But I feel like it should have been its own thing. It should have been its own miniseries. Or it should have just been a one shot. No, because then Justice League, I don't know how the Justice League issue is gonna get screwed over with this tie-in. So yeah, basically what I'm trying to say is that this shouldn't be issue number 33. This should be its own miniseries that ties into the Dark Knight's Metal. Just because it destroys the continuity of everything that happened earlier with the Flash. In fact, the only thing that actually stays the same is the fact that one, Barry and Iris are on the outs, and two, Iris killed Reverse Flash. Other than that, it ignores everything else. Ignores everything else that happened in the previous Flash issues. Flash doesn't have the negative speed force. Mina is not around. It's just, I don't know. I feel like, I mean, anyone who read issue 32 and is jumping into issue 33, it's going to seem really abrupt. Like you're almost reading a completely different series. And then I don't even know. I don't read Justice League, but I have a feeling that Justice League 31 and Justice League 32 are also going to feel like they're completely abrupt. Here's another thing that's kind of weird. Okay, it says next, the Justice League versus the Dark Knights in Justice League number 32. And in 2 weeks, Mina returns in Flash number 34, Black Hole Part 1. So I guess, do we just pretend that this issue never happened? Do we basically go from issue 32 of The Flash to issue 34? Because issue 32 ended the last arc, as well as set up for the next arc, which is going to start in issue 34. So why do this issue? Why make this Flash issue number 32 if this has no bearing whatsoever on the previous issues? I don't know. I just think that whole numbering system is weird. This really should have just been like a one-off. Or just rather than make this and then the Justice League 32 and then whatever other series you're going to take from, maybe just make this like a mini series. But yeah, I guess I didn't really care for that. So I guess we go back to regular Flash and his adventures with issue 34, and you can just pretend that issue 33 didn't happen. So I guess if you're not interested in the Dark Knight's Metal and you just want to collect the Flash series, skip this issue, because this issue has no bearing whatsoever on the Flash continuity. Like I said, it is a good issue. I really enjoyed it. I just, as a The Flash issue, it was not great. and the fact that it felt like a throwaway chapter that doesn't do anything to advance the plot that's been built up for the previous 32 issues. Yeah, I'm starting to ramble, so I'm gonna end the video here. Hope you guys enjoyed. I don't know, what do you guys think of this whole like numbering situation? For anyone who's been reading The Flash and then read this issue, do you think that it was a poor idea to make this issue number 33? Do you think, like me, they should have just made this like a one shot or put this somewhere else and then just continue with the return of Mina for issue 32 and just start that new arc? Yeah, just let me know down below. But yeah, don't, like I said, don't let this rambling rant kind of persuade you to not get this issue. It is a really good issue. I really enjoyed it. I feel like it could have been its own thing and didn't need to have the Flash number 33 attached to it. But yeah, hope you guys enjoy it, and I'll catch you guys all next time. Later.